I have always felt a connection with the character of Steve Rogers. Steve has an inspiring set of moral values that guide his life. But even more so, he does what he does because he believes in it, not because those around him tell him to. Steve Rogers is a true hero with a complete purpose. Who's your favorite superhero? How would you describe them? Would you say that they are a powerful character who's been gifted with unordinary powers? Well, maybe think again. Think about yourself right now. It's often the ordinary abilities that make a character heroic. To me, a superhero is someone who has the bravery to try and find out where they need to go in life, and once they've found it, admit, accept, and move towards it. I think we all have that inside of us. You may just not know it yet. I certainly didn't know at the age of 12. I spent ages 9 to 12 in London. Now, London is known to be a pretty multicultural city, but I wouldn't credit sixth graders with being the most accepting people in the world. It's 2014, I'm 12 years old, it's about 11 a.m. I'm picking dry paint off of the art room table at the American School in London. The bell signals freedom from the classroom, but before I escape, I must face the cage that had kept me captive for my whole life and many years to come. I make my way out of a heated conversation about the X-Men and other Marvel characters and over to the sink to wash out my palette. It wasn't heated because of any disagreements, but instead because I'd picked up a sprint, running away from the truth and ultimately myself. As I got to the sink, one classmate asked me if I was a big Marvel fan, and I lied because popular kids didn't like superheroes. Even as a child, my identity was shaped by the pressures of society. But what's most memorable about this moment, forever burned into my brain, was the fact that she could tell that as much as I could. Every day, superheroes are given a choice. Reveal their true identity to the world, or hide it. That day, I chose to hide it. Yeah, I know. Cruel origin story, huh? Well, I had my reasons. I ran from the truth because society told me I wouldn't succeed in accepting it, but also because I thought it would hurt my chances of being well-liked, and that was unhealthy. I grew up a very sporty kid, a product of who I was raised by. Of course, I don't blame my parents. They raised me well, and I'm forever thankful for that. But when you're the product of an All-American soccer star and a near-Olympic runner, athletics run deep in your blood. And that's how I wanted to be known, traveling side by side with my peers on the way to soccer matches, as an athlete. Because athletes were the people who had friendships. That's what I wanted, and I wanted it so badly. After moving back to the U.S. and into a new school, after a period of wearing athletic shirts with slogans like Eat, Sleep, Ball, or Just Do It inscribed upon them, in order not to be labeled as the nerdy kid, I eventually found the confidence to wear what I wanted to. Every morning, I had finally stopped waking up to a lie I didn't want to supply anymore. It felt freeing. Having the bravery to make that decision was the strength in my arm. No matter the size, I think we all have gone through shifts where we contemplate the difference between the identity the public world sees and the identity that we keep inside, and which one we choose to show. Being open is no small feat, and if you have the bravery to be yourself in this world that will constantly find a way to put you down, be proud. It's a long process, it sure was for me, which means even the small steps are something to be proud of. You're a superhero for trying to overcome your struggles. Even something like having the will to get up out of your bed in the morning and meet the day is an accomplishment in my eyes. Whatever it is you're doing, if you're trying, you're taking the right steps forward. I wish I would have known that when I was questioning my choice to be more open. I wish I would have known that on the weekend nights when I cried myself to sleep after watching the main characters of teen dramas having the best nights of their lives partying and thinking I wasn't invited to any because of who I was. I wish I would have known that when I faked being sick so I wouldn't have to go to school and physically face looking at everyone sharing their lives with those closest to them, and accepting that I had no one to do that with. If I knew what I'd do now, I would have known that my greatest heroic act was losing the need to fit in. Discovering this was the soul within my body. The biggest question they ask you in kindergarten or lower school is, what do you want to be when you grow up? The young mind doesn't quite know it, but subconsciously, when you answer that question, you're setting yourself down a path. The mind is most malleable when it's least developed, and giving your answer implants a goal in that sponge-like brain of yours. When I was asked that question, however many times, I always said I wanted to be a professional soccer player in the Barclays Premier League.
What was your favorite moment of the Barclays Premier League so far this season?
When Ben Percy scored that goal at the following game.
The British Soccer or Football League. So when I quit playing sports, I wasn't only letting go of everything that I had spent my entire life working towards, but I was also letting go of my innocence, realizing that not everything was going to come to me in some bright, perfect world, and accepting that I had to do something about myself. I had to really change. About 3 times a month, I think up a fake scenario where my younger self meets me today. It's interesting to me because we're completely different people. He'd be shocked at what I'd become, but I wouldn't blame him. I think all I could really tell him is that one day he'd be proud of himself. He might have been ashamed of the person he was once, but that doesn't matter to him anymore. Recently, I dyed my hair green and embraced my difference once again, and that's part of the superhero life. It's never simple, it never is, because the way the world's set up these days, everything has to be carefully calculated. We're taught that we have to hide every little thing about ourselves and paint a proper public picture of ourselves, in fear of judgment. I'd lie if I told you that not a single person gave me a weird look because of my new hair or asked me, "Why on earth would you do that?" in a condescending tone. Sometimes, most of the time, judgment isn't avoidable. But we need to change ourselves because we want to. I haven't avoided it in the changes I've made to myself, but I've also never felt more happy to be who I am. So next time you hesitate with being yourself, go out there, be wild, be free. Do the silly things you love doing, play the games you love playing with the people you love. Not to dismiss any judgment, but to find true happiness in being yourself. And who am I? Well, I'm like you, a superhero.